Okay, hi everyone. So I'm here to present my crowdfunding idea. This is a Dell Inspiron 525 from about 10 years ago with a Core 2 Duo processor worth about $5. It has a solid state drive. The ones I aim to use are faster than this one and will cost me $70 for a 256 gig one. All up, it would cost me about $80. This is a Dell Optiplex 3050 with a Core i3 current processor, DDR4 RAM as opposed to DDR2 RAM, and a standard spinning drive. And you would think still it is a faster computer. But this is not actually true. For 99% of the people, the Core 2 Duo from 10 years ago is more than fast enough, and what makes the most difference is the solid state drive. So first, let's just test and compare the speeds of the two computers. So let's give the expensive one a head start and get this one going. So they're both loading. The Dell logo there. This one is still loading. This one's loading. If we go back, this one's in Windows already. We are starting Chrome, Excel, and Word. So we are already productive. This one, we're still waiting on. And I guess what I'm trying to tell you is we are still waiting, while on the $80 computer, we are already browsing. We are already productive. I can open this again, and you can see the lack of lag. Now this is all finally loaded up. I try to turn on Chrome, and you can see the lag there. It's still not actually turning on. So that's an $800 computer, and this one has beat it substantially. $800, $80, so this is 10 times cheaper, and yet this computer is lagging, so it's still loading Chrome as we speak. And it's finally got there, and you know, we can type some stuff in there, but essentially, we are not seeing a 10 times improvement over 10 times in price. In fact, we are seeing this computer perform substantially better. And a lot of companies throw these types of computers out. Now, that's the bedrock, the pricing. It means I can get these computers very cheap, and then I can offer you customization in the form of art. I'm trying to combine computers with art. I ask you, why does a computer have to look like a boring black box? Or a boring black box like this? Currently, you can buy a printer that prints onto a 3D surface without distortion. So if you were to get a JPEG image, like an amazing one like this, in very, very high definition and DPI, you could position it when you come in the store to go on the sides, on the top, around the front, and become very much your own computer. You could take a snapshot of your own painting and do the same thing. So the computers I would be using would be this size, slightly bigger, smaller than this one, but they're all available for $25 to $40. So I can get them quite cheaply. They're very reliable, and I would stick to only a few models, maybe three models, and I would allow you to either put a JPEG image on it. It could even be a photo. Or you could get your kids to actually use a paintbrush, and I would have pre-painted painted white computers, and you can paint your own masterpiece on your own computer. You can make it look like a piece of wood, you can make it look like a Dali painting or a Matisse. My point is, why should a computer look like a boring black box when you can paint on it, you can print on it if you want something amazing like this in very high resolution or a photo, and you can get it cheaper, far cheaper than brand new computers like this, which are no faster than 10-year-old computers like this. In fact, the solid state drive version of this computer would match this computer in performance in terms of loading time and loading time of applications. So you've all been goaded into thinking you need a Core i7 or a Core i5 or even a Core i3. The fact is, a solid state drive makes far more difference than the processor. When 99% of you people are using the computer for browsing, YouTube, emails, Excel, even multitasking, the amount of RAM in there, no matter what type of RAM, and the solid state drive make far, far more difference in performance. And so what I'm offering you is a customized computer where you paint on it for a lesser price or a slightly higher price, maybe $50 more, a print of whatever JPEG image you want wrapped around the sides and the front. Now, if we look forward and imagine, we can imagine hospitals wanting white computers so they can be cleaned better, with the ward number printed on the side. We can imagine businesses wanting to customize their PCs for a new employee. Businesses throw a lot of money on their computers. Every 2 years they buy employees $1,000 computers. And the fact is that from 10 years ago until now, any given business could have kept this computer and just put a solid state drive in. Now, the backs of the monitors, likewise, we can put in to the printer and customize it. So you've got a completely customized computer, back of the monitor and the case. Or you can imagine it on a smaller scale or sort of medium. This is a little bit too big, but nobody needs massive computers these days, apart from gamers or people who are graphic artists and hardcore programmers. So companies would want this, individuals would want this, businesses would want this, and I hope my store will spread. You come in, sip on a cup of coffee after you've positioned your image on it, and after 15 minutes you get your computer. Or you might want to sit down and paint your own masterpiece for less than a quarter of the price of a computer you don't need, at a price you don't need. So yeah, bear with me, and I think we can change the world, we can change the environment, save the environment. A lot of these get thrown out, a lot of gold gets wasted, a lot of metals go into the earth. So not only are you helping yourselves by having a beautiful, if you use your imagination, a customized PC, you're saving the environment and saving yourself money. So I'm thinking of calling it Ink Art PC. So you can look at more of the details that I've written, and please help me. You know, my main budget is on marketing, getting people to know what's coming for a couple of weeks, getting people excited, and then rolling out these stores all over Australia, and then maybe going overseas to America, to Europe. So let's make something Australian, unique, which saves people money and stops companies like Intel from making you waste your money when the most important thing in terms of speed is this. So thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen, and I hope you help me achieve my goal and help you as well. Thank you. Bye.